Hello, welcome to Top Notch Tutorials. In the last session, we dealt with an algorithm of how to convert decimal numbers into binary numbers. In this session, we'll continue with the same discussion. Instead, we'll take a few more problems to understand the basic algorithm in detail. Let us take examples like number 17, 1102, and 607. Let us consider number 76. Now the algorithm says that if the number is even, we write down 0, and if the number is odd, we write down 1. As 76 is an even number, we write down 0, and we directly divide it by 2 to get 38. Now this number is again even, so we divide it by 38, write down 0 to get 19. Now, as 19 is an odd number, we subtract 1 from it, that is 18. We divide it by 2 and we get 9. We keep up with this algorithm. As 9 again is odd number, we write down 1, subtract 1 from 9, which is 8, and divide it by 2 to yield 4. Now, 4 is an even number, we write down 0, divided by 2 to get 2, again divided by 2 to get 1, which is an odd number, we write down 1, subtract 1 from 1, and we get 0, and there our process ends. So the number which is shown over here has its MSB at the downmost position and LSB at the topmost position. So we construct our binary number from MSB to LSB, and so this is how it looks. So binary of number 76 is 01001100. Let us consider our next example. The process is similar to double double method. You just don't have to consider any tables in this process. So 1102 is an even number, we write down 0, divided by 2 we get 551, which is an odd number, we write down 1, subtract 1 from it, we get 550, and divided by 2 to get 275, which is again an odd number. We subtract 1 from 275 and divide by 2 to get 137, 137 being again odd. Subtract 1 to get 136, dividing it by 2 yields 68, which is an even number, so we write down 0, and we simply divide 68 by 2 to get 34, which is again even. We divide by 2 to get 17. As 17 is an odd, we write down 1, subtract 1 from it to get 16, divide 16 by 2 to get 8, and as 8 is an even number, we write down 0. We continue this process for number 4, dividing 4 by 2 yields us 2, which is again even. Dividing 2 by 2 yields us 1, 1 being odd, we write down 1, subtract 1 from it to get 0, and the process ends. So our binary representation of number 1102 can be written as 01001001110. As discussed earlier, the number coming at the last is our MSB, while the first number is our LSB. And there you go. There we have the binary representation of number 1102. Let us consider one more example, which is 607. We just have to judge whether the number is even or odd. Now, as 607 is odd number, we write down 1. Subtract 1 from it and divide it by 2, which is 303. Again, it is an odd number, so we subtract 1 from it, which yields us 302, and we divide it by 2. It again gives us 151, which is again an odd number. So we write down 1, subtract 1 from it, which is 150, dividing it by 2 yields us 75, which is odd. We write down 1, subtract 1 from 75, which gives us 74. dividing it by 2 gives us 37, which is again odd. And we continue this process once again, which yields us 18. Now 18 being even, we write down 0 and simply divide it by 2, which gives us 9. 9 again being odd, we write down 1, subtract 1 and dividing it by 2 gives us 4, 2, 1 and 0. And this is how we construct our binary representation of number 607, which is 01001 0 1 1. So that's it for today. I would recommend all of y'all to take up some random numbers and practice them so that you get good hold over this algorithm. This algorithm is pretty fast, and if you practice it, you'll be able to acquire a good hold over conversions from decimal to binary. Thank you for watching this video. If you have missed out anything in this video, please make sure that you revisit the previous video, as the basic concepts have been dealt in the previous video of how to apply the algorithm. Thank you.